I'm talking about.
He is actually, how is he still on it? No. No.
This is what a full beard looks like.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3.
What's happening, boys, and welcome to the Inform Legend Kanaplayanka episode. Before we get in the episode, I just want to say that we're probably going to try to get a little bit more festive for the next couple weeks. We got Thanksgiving coming up. For those of you guys that celebrate it, we also have Christmas and all the other holidays that happen around this time of year. So, in order to be more festive, we got to get more festive. How do you do that, bro? You start out with a hot chocolate. You also want some lights, bro.
Yeah, dude.
You also want the right clothing attire, and I think this looks pretty fucking festive, bro. This looks mad festive, yo. One more thing is missing. We need a little bit of snow. Also, another thing I want to point out is this is probably the craziest my beard gets. Like, when I wear white, you can really tell where the hair is growing in. I can't grow any facial hair, but for the entire month of November, I'm going to be trying to grow this out and see how long it can get. RIP my manliness. Like I said, boys, we are here to look at the informed version of Kanaplayanka, who looks pretty sick, didn't get a whole ton of upgrades, had plus 42 overall stats. The most noticeable upgrade is probably his strength, which went from 69 to 73, so we got a plus 4 upgrade there. Didn't have many upgrades in his shooting stats, which are already pretty solid. But yeah, the physical one is the one you will notice the most. He had 66 physical, and now he's up to 70, so he got, yeah, plus 4, if I'm not mistaken. I'm pretty sure that's correct. 4-star reload, 4-star skill moves. You guys know that he's already a beast. I played him up front in an episode before. We've paired him with Griezmann and James Rodriguez, who we didn't use before. Before, we had Ferreira Carrasco, the Belgian inform from a few weeks ago. We also had Disco Isco, but now we're using James Rodriguez, and the rest of the squad is pretty much the same. But like I said, boys, this is the squad. We've got Alan Pardew in there, up to 38% smack my bitch up bonus. He is in España watching Vicky Cristina Barcelona, the Christmas edition. And yeah, looks like a beast squad. Krychowiak shows up more often than not. Really, really happy with that particular player. Not a lot of people use him, even though he's one of the better defensive midfielders in La Liga BBVA. If you guys do enjoy the video, make sure to hit that like button. Let's try and blast 50 likes as well. If you want to interact with me on Instagram and Twitter, those links can be found in the description below. Let's turn the air down a bit. Get it real chilled up in this piece. Let's get into a match. Let's see how informed Kanaplayanka performs. All right, boys, so here we go. Coming up against Braithwaite, who studied at Hogwarts. We're coming up against Alessandrini. We've got Valbuena. He's got Ruffier. He's got Nkulu. He's got Serge Aurier. He's got Esu Okoto, I believe. And then Bafuma or the other guy. Ah, fuck, I don't know his name. Shit horse, I don't know his name. So I went on a 3-day vacation. I haven't played FIFA in 3 days. So we're going to see if somehow I've retained my skills. Because I'm feeling incredibly rusty right now. So hopefully, Kanaplayanka is such a beast card that it doesn't even feel like I've left the game. Oh, what the fuck? Cunt. This guy is a cunt. Oh, shit. Shit! Great save from Bravo. How the fuck did that go in? No, seriously. How did that actually go in? That took a deflection. Because Bravo... What the fuck was that goal? Well, I'm playing like absolute shit. One shot on target? James! Oh. Holy shit, what a fucking rip from Kanaplayanka! What the actual shit? Was that a first touch? Dead fish. Yo, we gotta see that 79th minute. We had no chances all match. But that's the one we needed right there. Was that first touch? Oh my god. What a fucking rip. First time playing with James? Can he rip one? Oh fuck, I thought that was in. So we played a lot better in the second half. Got ourselves that goal all due to Kanaplayanka. Had a shot with James Rodriguez that I thought had a chance of going in. Let's get an extra time. Let's fucking win this thing. Fucking James, come on, bro. You've had two chances to put the game away. Right here. This is why we signed you. That's why we fucking signed you, bro. 2-1. James Rodriguez. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I needed. 105th minute. Come on, boys. We can do this. 15 shots, 11 on target. I can't believe how much we've shut him down in the second half and turned it up in the second half. Let's go. Nah. He's still on it. He is actually. How is he still on it? No.
my god!
What kind of skill run was that? What the actual fuck skill run was that right there? Did I say skill one?
Yo!
Holy shit! I didn't think I was putting that away! And he tucks it away beautifully! Konoplyanka, you ledge! You rage quit in the 118th minute. I don't get the logic. Konoplyanka, 2 goals, only 8.3 rating, which I don't understand. I guess Rodriguez was the guy that turned it around, and then Konoplyanka with the 3rd goal put the game out of reach for my opponent. 18 shots, 13 on target, and only 48% possession. We just turned it up in the second half. Let's get into match number 2. All right, boys, here we go, coming up against a pretty sweet full Belgian side. I feel like I played this squad a couple episodes ago, a full Belgian squad. I've come up against a French one, and I've come up against a Belgian one. This looks very similar to the one I played.
Oh, Konoplyanka. Come on, bro. Little bit of no-touch dribbling. Little bit of Ukrainian dancing.
Shit.
Cue the Ukrainian music. Put something on.
Yes. Yo, PK's a fucking beast. What is it about first halves in FIFA that make it impossible to score? I just can't score, regardless of whatever match I'm playing with. I can never score in the first half. Griezmann, that's it.
That's it.
Wait a second. Wait a
second. Konnichiwa, you have to do better than that, bro.
6 shots, 4 on target. He's got 0 shots on target. I need to convert. 56% possession. We're dominating right now. Let's freaking go.
I'm not getting crazy. No way. No way.
Hey, yo, his name is
Jeff. Holy shit. Konoplyanka makes the run of dreams. 53rd minute. As soon as the second half starts, I just start scoring. What the actual shit horse?
Yo, that was a crazy run from Konoplyanka, to be honest with you.
Again, I don't know if he would have done that with 69 strength or if that's the plus four that brings him up to 73 strength. Oh, shit. Oh, no. I thought that was my player. Oh, fucking bravo, thank God. Oh, Hummus! Yo, Mignolet has been blocking some pretty serious shots from distance. Haven't been able to be imposing from distance. Maybe this goes in. Maybe. Oh, fuck. Wait a second. PK's trying to be a hero now. And that.
How many times do we have to do the post? Like, seriously, how many times do we have to hit the post?
Ref, blow the whistle. There we go. 2 wins in a row. Both matches due to the freaking skills of Konoplyanka. 13 shots, 9 on target, 55% possession. Again, absolute domination. In the last match, we had a little bit more of a challenge in the first half, even the second half, but we turned it up big time. Konoplyanka stepped up in both matches. Let me know in the comment section below if you guys use him. I say only, but 100k is sort of cheap right now, so I would say definitely let me know in the comment section below if you think he is worth it or not. Honestly, he didn't play much different than his regular card for me, but yeah, it's always interesting experimenting with an inform card. Does he perform worse? Does he perform better? For me, really, really couldn't tell a difference. Probably better to use his card, his regular card, which is 10 times cheaper. It's actually like 100 times cheaper. But anyway, boys, if you did enjoy the episode, make sure to hit that like button. If you guys are new to the channel, hit that subscribe button down below. I will see you guys for another upload tomorrow. Till next time, tschüss, later, ade.
I thought this was the Evil Academy.
There's no one here by this name.
But on